Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, thank you for joining us. We have a really exciting thing going on. I'm very excited to show you these cute little tea bag embellishments. I've had several requests for tutorial on how I did them, and here I am going to show you them step by step. Really super easy, anybody can do these, and so we will get on with it. I will put these aside and tell you what you will be needing, what we'll be needing for our project here. And first thing that we will need is tea bags, used and dried. What I do with my tea, we drink a lot of tea, and I just hang it from the cabinet door when I'm done using it, and they dry over a couple of days, and then I save them. And then what I wind up with later is these. These are them. These are tea bags that I've opened up, taken the tea out of, and put in my plants. I also have these little round ones, as you saw in some of the other ones. You're going to need tea bags so that you can wind up with empty tea bags like this. You're going to need book pages from an old book that fell apart or that you know is not going to be read anymore. Don't feel bad. The book is being put to good use. This book fell apart as my husband was reading it because he'd read it so many times. And anyway, so I'm using its pages now. We also will need scissors. I think the little ones are probably better depending on the situation that you're going to use them for, but I got a couple of pairs here. Another thing that you'll need is paintbrush, any size will do, a pencil, a cereal bag liner such as this, or a piece of wax paper. Also, you're going to need some glue solution. What this isn't Elmer's, but you can use Elmer's. What this actually is this. It's Amazon clear school glue. I bought it. It was cheap. I bought it like a year or more ago, maybe 2 years, and it's already still half full. And I use this in here, 2/3 of the glue and then 1/3 of water. Shake it up. And if you want, this is totally optional, but if you have, I'm not finding out, if you have essential oils laying around, I really enjoy putting a drop or two in my glue solution, because it makes it so much more enjoyable when you're using the glue. It smells good. The last batch I did was lavender, but you can use anything you want. Another thing that you're going to need is either a 2-inch round thing. This is for when we're doing our round tea bags, or if you're fortunate enough to have a 2-inch circle or hole punch, you can use that. But honestly, I've used both methods and they're equally as effective. I will show you how to do that. Another thing that we'll need is, and these are just optionals here, is I've got some distress ink and an inker. This is for inking edges of the pages. I like to use either this walnut stain or the vintage photo. Those are my favorites. This gives you the look of the edges being inked. This is the look without them being inked. So it's just whatever you want. On some of the ones I've done here, I inked some of the edges and some of them I did not. This one, it looks like I did. This one looks like I did. The round ones looks like I did. But then looking at these, it looks like I did not, but it still looks good. So you don't have to, it just depends on what you're after. Another thing that's optional is a sewing machine. These look super, super cute with sewing around them. I really like the way they look. So if you have a sewing machine, by all means, and you enjoy using it, you would want to use this on this project, because it just gives such unique designs to it. But if you don't have a sewing machine, don't fear, because we can make some mock stitches, such as I have done on this, simply using a
Sharpie. So if you don't have a sewing machine, never fear, marker will work just as fine. Another option for embellishing, you can use stamps, you can use stickers. I got a bunch of them here that I just kind of picked out for the project. You can use pretty much anything you know you want to embellish. You can use napkins to decoupage. You can use fabrics, whatever you want. So I'm gonna start with the regular shaped tea bags. Okay, what we got here is basically these. And this is not brain science, rocket science, but I'm just gonna show you really quick how I take apart a tea bag so that it is intact as much as possible. I just simply take off the string, open it up, and this tea is not going to go to waste. It's going to be used. I'm going to put it in plants, so it'll be reconstituted. And what we want to do is carefully not only dump out the tea, but we want to open the tea bag without tearing it, which can be tricky if it's already slightly torn like this one is. But don't worry, if it is, when we glue it, it's going to be non-noticeable. You won't see that it's torn. And you notice from with each tea bag, what you get is this beautiful, beautiful patina from the tea. And it really makes a difference. It makes every one of them be completely different and very antique looking. You know, some of them are darker than others, some of them are lighter than others, but they all have their own character, and it makes it really interesting. So I opened it, that's it, that's all you need to do. So put that aside, and then this one. Oh, also, I was taking off these edges. I don't know if it really matters, but it seemed like it makes it less defined on the edge. So you have kind of a raggedy look around the edges. I don't know. I don't know if it makes any difference at all, but I was saving these and then I wound up making a little tassel. Da-da-da-da. What we'll need next is our book pages. So we've got book pages and we want to make them fit our tea bag. So what I like to do is use a ruler. You can either use a ruler and tear, like I'm about to do, or you can use the scissors and cut. I take a few at a time, and I just want those white edges off because I don't want the white edges to be shown. I do have some that have some white edges a little bit. I mean, it's no big deal. And then of course these papers that I'm putting aside, I'm saving. I'm totally saving these as scraps. They won't go in the garbage. They will be used. They will be used in a different project another time. So yes, we'll put those aside. So we get the white edges off. And then what we want to do is make the paper match the tea bag. So what we'll do, fold the tea bag in half, and I got a few pieces of paper here. What I do to measure, I don't measure anything. I just eyeball it. So what I do, instead of making it match up perfectly on this paper, I just put it a little bit down and a little bit off to the left, and then I take my pencil. And I draw a line, another line, and then I'm going to tear this as well. Again, you can cut it. This won't take as long when you're doing it as it does now. I'm just, because I'm showing it to you step by step. So let's see if this fits. Yay! So there we go. It's a perfect fit. So now what we're going to do is the fun part. What I like to do is ink edges. Again, this is perfectly optional. You don't have to do it if you don't have ink. If you don't have a dauber, don't worry. If you have anything brown like shoe polish or paint or anything, marker even, you can use a marker, brown marker, and do the edges if you don't have ink. The point is, I don't want you to have to go out and buy things you don't need just to make things look pretty. You really, really can do this on the cheap with almost no money at all. So, you know, I'm using this makeup, which I use for a dark purple normally, but it works just as fine as my ink dauber. So I'm going to ink these. It really kind of gives it some definition and really gives it more of a vintagey look. So there, we got that all nice and darker on the edges. You can use a different color. You can use black, whatever, doesn't matter. Just whatever your heart's desire is. So, and then we'll put this inside here. I'm actually going to get a bigger one. This looks like it's a little bit short. This one works well. This one doesn't have as much of a patina, but it has a little bit. Each one is its own. I'll tell you, it's neat. So what we can do here is one of two things. You can get, if you have some glue stick, it's not necessary, but you could, you know, by all means, stick it in there with a little bit of glue stick, like so, so that it stays in place. And then now would be the time that you would take this to your sewing machine and sew around the edges, such as the way I did in these different ones here. You'll see here I did a zigzag stitch, very tight, and it looks completely different on the back. And see that I didn't decorate this other side, but these are really two-sided embellishments. Sewing is super nice, but if you don't have a sewing machine, don't fear, because we can make our own little stitches. Zigzag, zigzag, maybe. Do a zigzag stitch here. So I am going to pretend I don't have a sewing machine, and because at one time I didn't, and so I am going to just pretend I have sewn this all around. And it doesn't have to be perfect because it is handmade. And I don't sew perfect anyway, unless I'm trying to hurry. Okay. There, we've sewn it. We will decorate. Now, there's any different kinds of ways that we can decorate this. Like I said, you can use stamps, you can use stickers, you can use decoupage little images that you want to put on there. I would just like to take a moment to talk about stickers a little bit, because through trial and error, I learned a few different things. Now, when I was making these, I found out that stickers that are like glossy, like this, these ones, they don't work as well, I didn't think. And also, if they have like, you know, where they're see-through-ish, you see, I used, and plus the glossy, and this was like a glossy clear that I had printed out. This was a matte clear that I printed out, but you can't really see it. It really get the children really get washed out, and I'm not fond of the glossy on there. So if you don't want this look, I mean, it's not bad, but you just can't see them as much as you can like with her and with them. And these are just plain paper fussy cut stickers that I printed out and made. Point being, be careful the stickers that you use, or by all means use something 3D like this, so you know for sure that there's not going to be a problem with it getting lost in the design. Another lost design. What we'll do is, in order to keep it simple, I am going to just use a sticker. I had a couple of them kind of picked out that I was thinking I might use. I like this one, this typewriter. And then I also had this one. No guts, no story. So I like those. I'm going to use those, I think. I think I'll ink the edge of this just because, again, I like the look of that. So if you decide to use stamps, I'd like to talk a little bit about stamps, because if you're new at using stamps, sorry, had to concentrate for a minute. If you're new at using stamps, like I'm relatively new and have just recently found out that if you use ink to stamp images like I did on some of these, make sure that you use one that's waterproof. I've used this one and I think that one made it blur. But if you want to use, if you want a nice crisp, clear image like this one, which I haven't glued this one yet, we can do that together because it's really, really pretty. Use something that's waterproof. This Ranger brand is really, really good. So, and they'll last for a long time. Anytime your ink starts to get dry, just give it a little squirt of water and it's good as new. So I'm gonna put this on. Another sticker, typewriter. No guts, no story. And since it's a two-sided design, we can do the other side too. Oh, how about this one? I like this. Shoe. The shoe and maybe this sticker. Just be you. Like it. Okay. So since this one's got like white around the edge and stuff, I don't want that. I'm going to tear off the edges so that it looks a little bit more jagged on the edges, and when I ink around the edge, it'll take better. I carefully kept all the words intact. Just ink that a little bit, that baby, and stick. You know, I've made my own stickers by printing out many free digitals that are legit free digitals, and I got sticker paper that I bought and just put in my printer, and all I have to do is cut them out and there they are, ready for use. So you don't have to pay for a lot of stickers. If you have a printer, you can get some nice ones for free. Just be you and wear a silly shoe. So there. So that one's ready for me. Simple. I mean, we could go crazy. We could really go crazy and decorating it, but I'm going to keep it simple just for time's sake, because I'm going to go ahead and put this aside and we're going to move on to the round ones now. And these are really fun. You can get round tea bags a lot of times in canisters at like places like Big Lots or Tuesday Morning or something where they sell, you know, things for cheap. And you can, I think I got a stack of chai tea bags for like $3 or $4. So that gives you these little round ones. And this one's got a really pretty patina. And for some reason, these ones, which I think I made out of made sun tea, they didn't wind up leaving a patina at all. So these are going to be kind of clear and not as interesting maybe, but they will be because it depends on what we do to decorate it. So I want to show you what I did to cut the tea bag. And what I did was I took my tiny pair of scissors and I just snipped all across the top back. And I'll show you an example of one that I've done. You see? So now that I've got this paper, I can stick it in the back here. I'll show you in a minute how to make the circle papers. So that is how you do that. It's not any more complicated than that. Again, the same thing with inking the edges. It's entirely optional and up to you. But I want to show you how you can get your nice round circles like this. You can use this. Doesn't have to be cayenne pepper, obviously. What you're needing is something that is about 2 inches across. Take a stack of paper and take your pencil, put it out, you know, if you don't like, if you like just the words like I do, put it in the middle-ish where it starts, where the white ends. Just draw a circle around it, and there you go. I went ahead and I think I cut through 8 pieces of paper in order to get these. And I think that they look just as good as the ones that I used this 2-inch circle punch, in which I got these. But they look just as good, and really it took about just the same amount of time. So it doesn't matter how you do it, it's your choice. And you don't have to run out and buy a circle punch if you don't have one. Just look around your kitchen, you'll find something that's the right size. So basically we've got one ready. Why don't we just go ahead and decorate it? Let's see. I kind of like this. Did I ink the edges? Yes, I did. I kind of like this. A 3-hour tour. And then maybe, look at her. She kind of covers up everything, so maybe not. Oh, how about a clock? Yeah, that would work. I think that looks good. Again, simple. It's very simple, but effective. And if I wanted to, you know, really what I could do, since I'm like, oh, this isn't very tea stained, I can act like it is. I can act like it is if I want to. It's just whatever you want. Now it's tea stained. So there we go. Okay, so we'll put the clock on this side. You can decide which way you want your book page to face, if you want it parallel with the little lines on the side, which I kind of like. It's, or you know, you can get funky and do it cockeyed and wonky. Doesn't matter. It's your thing. It's your embellishment. You can do anything you want with it. There are so many options. And if you make one that doesn't turn out good, it doesn't matter. It's just an old tea bag that, and some old piece of paper that would have just got thrown away anyway, and it, you had a good time making it. So that's what matters. It's just enjoying the process, having fun, being creative, and maybe coming up with some cute old things, you know, that you didn't expect. So there we go. Just a simple little circles on circles. And we'll just keep it simple there. And then I also have some of these others that I haven't yet done the glue on. So I'm going to go ahead and do those now while we're here. And again, I'm going to use the archival ink. Okay, not sure exactly which one, but one of them is the archival waterproof ink, and another one of these last ones is the ink pad. So we're gonna, I think it's this one. So we'll find out after I paint the glue on top of everything, if they smear or not. But I'm gonna go ahead and use this because I suspect it will, and I don't want it to. We'll go ahead and use another tea kettle. Another tea bag. Tea kettle on a tea bag. I'll do one more. Here. Yay! I think it looks really sweet. Okay. So then, as far as cleaning off the ink on my inker, I just ink some scratch paper until it's clear, and it's fine doing it that way. So I'm filming this upside down, so I'm confusing myself a little and not sure exactly how I'm going to display the video, so bear with me while I figure that out. Now comes the fun part. Okay, we've decorated these and we have to do one side at a time in terms of gluing. So I will do one side now. And what I do is I take my glue, shake it well, my glue solution, and I've got my paintbrush. You can use any paintbrush or anything that resembles a paintbrush. I just put the glue right on top. And I paint the glue. Okay, looks like we've learned something here. The dye ink definitely smears. So just put on enough glue until you've got it all pretty well saturated. Here's the one we did together, the one that's not sewn. So let's see how that one turns out. Okay, so paint it from the inside, the middle out, so that way your tea bag doesn't fold over upon itself like I just did right here. If it does, you can fix it. See? Look, it's looking good. Looking good already. Let's see how the wheel looks. Looking good, looking good. And see, you can't even hardly see the slit that I made. This one's the back side because it's glued. I fixed it with glue. So that one looks good. This one, you see how once you've put the solution, everything just comes out. So here's one I didn't ink around the edges of the paper, the book page, and you can see the difference. Again, this one's the back side of the tea bag, and I just need to, I probably will edit this out. But then again, you know, this kind of shows what happens in real life, so maybe I won't, you know. I'm no expert by any means. I'm learning as I go. This is all new to me. As new to me as it is to anybody else. So I'm just kind of making it up as I go. So if you're still with us, I want to thank you for watching the video. I'd like for you to leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section and like if you like this video. Maybe subscribe. That'd be pretty cool if you like this. If you have any ideas of anything that you would like me to show you how to make, let me know. I'll do whatever I can. Okay, see, we got here left. That's been stamped with the waterproof ink and it is not smearing. So there we go. That one I didn't do the back of that. That's okay. It is okay. So voila, we have the ones we made and the ones that I had not glued earlier. And now all we do is we wait until they're dry. If it's not too windy outside, you can take your wax paper outside and let them dry out there. If not, just come back and they don't take real long to dry, depending on the humidity. And then you turn them over and then you just glue the other side. And then you wind up with these cute little darlings. So, and as you might tell, I also inked around the edges of these stickers. So that's how that look became. Well, thank you again for everybody for watching and you have a good day. See you next time. Bye-bye.